Do you wish you were booking more appointments without lifting a finger? Today, I'm going to show you how to set up the scheduler in Dubsado to connect with your lead capture forms so that you can have it working for you as if you had a personal assistant. If you have ever gone back and forth with a client trying to find the best time that both of you can meet for an appointment, you know that it is so frustrating, and I am here to help. I've recorded a step-by-step tutorial on exactly how to set up the scheduling template in Dubsado, connect it to your website, and even set up email reminders. As a virtual assistant that specializes in setting up automated systems for creative entrepreneurs, I have helped dozens of people set up this scheduler to eliminate the need for a full or part-time assistant. So I'm so excited to show you this today. Before we get into the tutorial, I just want to let you know that every single Wednesday I post a productivity and efficiency tip for entrepreneurs. So be sure to hit the subscribe button for Coffee with Christy and the bell to get notifications so you can start working smarter, not harder. All right, let's go into the tutorial. All right, so once we are in our Dubsado dashboard, we're going to go over to templates on the left-hand side here, and we're going to click the scheduler. Once we do that, we're going to add a template on the top right here, and we're going to create a new appointment scheduler that can be used as many times as you'd like. So we're going to call this one just free consultation. Now, the example that I'm going to be giving you is a 15-minute free consultation that I offer personally for my for people who are inquiring about my Dubsado services. And so I typically have this on my website after somebody has filled out a contact form. They are redirected to this appointment scheduler, so I'm going to show you how to do that. When can this appointment be scheduled? Of course, it's going to be indefinitely. I always want my clients to be able to book with me whenever works for them. But I do need to set my availability. So on Wednesday afternoons, I'm actually not available at all. So that's going to be all Wednesdays. But on Thursdays, I'm available between 1 p.m. and 5 p.m. That's all Thursdays. Fridays, I'm only available in the mornings from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. all Fridays. And Mondays, I'm not available. And Tuesdays, I'm available in the afternoon as well. 1 to 5. All right, so once you've set your availability, you can go over to the bottom here. What I typically do is I have my location being Zoom. So I go over to Zoom and I copy my personal meeting ID. This allows everything to be completely automated always. And I'm just gonna go into the notes on my computer to just get the exact link, because typically it will, give you this entire thing. What we really just want is this. So we're going to copy that and we'll say online via Zoom, and I put that here. So again, that's my personal meeting ID. So I do not generate an automatic, a new Zoom link for every single client. I just send them the exact same Zoom link every single time, and it always works out really well. Now, this is just if you were to send this appointment scheduler by itself without somebody inquiring through your website, what you would say. But I just leave the default because I typically don't send this to people unless they're inquiring on my website. So that's the basic settings. Now we're going to go into advanced. So I like to prevent my booking less than 48 hours in advance because I do plan my schedule around my appointments. I do like to create a 15-minute window before and after each appointment, simply because if the meeting runs over, I think it would be kind of awkward, since I do use my personal meeting ID on Zoom and everybody gets the same one. That means that anybody could just hop in. So if somebody's coming on to their call a little bit early, if they have an appointment at 3:30, say, and I had another one from 3:15 to 3:30, I would be a little bit worried that those two would overlap and they would see each other. So I always create a window before and after each appointment, so Dubsado does not let people book within 15 minutes of each other. This is totally fine, displaying the available time slot in increments of 30 minutes. I allow a maximum of 3 appointments per day, so I don't overbook myself. And this is to allow the scheduler to be used a certain amount of times. So you would use this if you're maybe like a coach and you only have 10 spots available or something like that. You could cut it off so that if somebody tries to book after you've booked it 10 times, be like, sorry, all spots are filled, try next time. The welcome message, I usually do something cute like, let's chat about automated systems in your business. And then the confirmation email is something that you have pre-written in your canned email sections of Dubsado. Make sure you subscribe to Coffee with Christy, because I'm actually doing a video next week all about canned email responses in your business. So make sure you subscribe to see that. So we're going to choose the appointment confirmation email, and then we can actually set up appointment reminder notifications over here as well. So I'm going to click that. I want them to be alerted 2 hours before their meeting, and I've got an appointment reminder canned email that I've already written, and I add that. These two here are just additional forms. If you'd like them to fill out a form before they book the invite, then you can put that here. Or you can also require a deposit to secure the booking. So you can check that and say, you know, if you're an online coach, you can say coaching and it's X amount of dollars. Add the item and Dubsado will actually generate an invoice before they can actually submit their appointment. Monthly view is just how you'd like your client to see it. I usually like to let them see weekly view. All right, then we're going to go ahead and save that, and we have all of that information on the free consultation. So now what we're going to do is connect it to the lead capture form that's going on your website. So we're going to go again over here underneath templates into forms, and we'll go over to the initial inquiry lead capture form. So this is whatever you've chosen to be your initial inquiry lead capture form. So this, what it's going to look like on your website is you can either embed this in here, or you can share it this way going, this is how you embed it by clicking share, or you can go a direct link, and I'll show you this on my website too. So when you have this lead capture form, whatever information you need to know about your client is going to be here. And then what you do is you're going to go into the settings, and we're going to redirect URL, we're going to put in the redirect URL the link to the appointment scheduler. So let's go get it. We're in the scheduler here. Going to go over here, copy this link here. Oops, I didn't click it. Copy. So we're clicking that little link. Then we're going back to the lead capture form, going into settings, and pasting that scheduler link. That means that when somebody fills out this form on your website, they're going to automatically be directed to scheduling an appointment with you. So that's great. We're going to save that, and now we are ready to check it out on your website. All right, so after you've embedded the form in your website, or you've set it up so that when somebody clicks a button, it leads them to the link to fill out the form, it's going to look like this. You can click this, schedule your free call, and they're going to submit all the information that you need to do, that you need to put in. So I'm just going to do it like this so that you can see it. All right, now we're going to submit the questionnaire, and we're going to automatically be redirected to book an appointment. And this is so, so, so nice. It is so easy. We'll just book here, 3 p.m., submit. They will put in their information, submit. So that is how you set up your appointment scheduler and lead capture forms for ease of booking in Dubsado. So friends, I hope that this tutorial helped you. If you're a Dubsado user, let me know below if you'd like more tutorials just like this one. And if you haven't ventured into the world of automated systems and organization, then go ahead and grab my free checklist on how to set up your brand new Dubsado account at coffeewithchristy.com/Dubsado-checklist, or just by clicking the link below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.